Welcome back guys, welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, I will show you guys how you can create this cool 3D text effect in Adobe Illustrator. These 3D texts are vector and you guys can edit them as well. You can change the text, you can change the color. All changes you make will be re-rendered in vector format based on your lighting and material. Today we are going to see how to create this type of artwork and apply the lighting and materials. Before we start, let's look into our sponsored message first. Today's video is brought to you by Envato Elements. Envato Elements is an unlimited subscription service for digital assets. You can download print designs, web templates, CMS templates, stock images and footages, presentation templates, fonts, and many, many more digital assets. So if you are a graphic designer or content creator or even an agency, this is the one-stop service for you to fulfill your day-to-day needs. All of these digital assets are created by independent professional designers and creators who frequently upload new assets to the Envato Elements, so your library will grow every month with thousands of new assets. All of these for one subscription fee. Check out Envato Elements today. Link is under the description below. Alright, first I'm going to create a background for this artwork. So I will rename this layer as BG and go to the rectangle and draw a rectangle to cover the artboard. And we can lock this layer for now. For the text, I will create a new layer. So go in here and create a new layer and we can rename this as text layer. Alright. First, let's type some dummy text in here. For this example also, I'm going to type the same text as earlier. I will try to keep it in 3 or 4 lines. For this example, I will try to place the text similar to earlier version. You guys can have any text in here, it doesn't matter. So in our earlier version, we had the 3D on top, TYP in the second line. In the third line, we had the oh crap. I think the last part was in the fourth line. So let's create the last part in here. And we are done. Now let's arrange all these texts to same width. And we have to place them closer together vertically. Now we can align them to the center. And then we can apply the fill colors. Keep in mind guys, these colors you are applying will change based on our materials and lighting. So when you apply the colors, you guys need to consider the materials and how it will change based on the light placement. But don't worry, you guys can always change the color with the filter. Alright, first I will apply a yellow tone for all these texts. Somewhere around here should be alright. Next, select these texts individually. Apply a light gray tone, almost closer to white, but not 100% white, somewhere around here to these individual texts and lines. Okay, so I will randomly select these and apply this gray color again. You guys can copy the value from the gray color and apply to other places. Reason for this: if you use the eyedropper tool directly, it will copy the colors, but it will also copy the appearance from the text. So your original text will change to the eyedropper selection. We don't want that. We only need the color from that text. All right. Okay. Now we can bring these texts closer together vertically. The closer you place, nicer it will look in the final artwork. Now select all of them and make as a group. This step is very important guys. You have to make them as a group. If not, the effect we are going to apply will apply to individual text lines. Now make 2 more copies from this text group. Select the first text group and go to effects, 3D and materials, and select rotate. And in the presets in here, select the isometric left. Okay. Now select the second text, go to filters and apply rotation again. This time in the presets, apply isometric right. Finally, select the last text, go to filters and select apply rotation again. This time in the presets, you guessed it, apply isometric top. Okay, now we have all the components necessary to create our cube. All we need to do is place them in a cube formation. Something like this is fine. As you guys can see, it's not a cube anymore because we haven't placed the text in a square. Our width and height was not same. So that's why we are getting something like this. So we can delete the 3D from this part. So we will have a box like this. Okay, so all we're trying to create is a 3D isometric shape. If you guys want a perfect cube, you need to place the text in a square. Your width and height should be same. Alright, now let's apply the 3D depth for these characters. Select the top text group and go to the 3D and materials. In here, select the extrude and in the depth, type 200 pixels. You guys can have any value you want. I'm just going to stick to the 200 pixels. I'm going to repeat this step for all three of these text groups. So let's do that. Select this, go to the extrude and 200 depth. Same for this one in here as well. Alright, so now with the depth, we have to rearrange them to a cube again. We may need to rescale a bit if we want to. So let's place them nicely and try to make it as a box look as possible. I want that isometric look. So we can make these bigger and place it in here. And yeah, this should be alright. Okay, this look fine now. If you guys are new to 3D materials and render, what you guys see in here in the artboard is actually not the final artwork. For the final artwork, we have to render these materials, okay? What you see now is before render. So to render, we need to apply a material and values. So in here, if you go in here, by default, when you apply 3D materials, it will apply this default material, which is perfectly fine. So now we can adjust the roughness and metallic look from here. For an example, if you increase the roughness, you can see the material look will change. But you won't see any difference until you render. To render, you have to go in here. Press this one once. If you press and hold this button in here, it will automatically keep on render based on your changes. Okay, so if I change the metallic look or roughness now, you guys can see the material is rendering automatically based on my changes. So I'm going to keep the automatic rendering on and going to make these changes, and I'm going to make the same changes to other two 3D sets as well. So when I go in here, all I need is press the render button, and same for the other one as well. Okay, cool. So what you guys see now is the final version, rendered version. So this is how our artwork is going to look in the final version. Alright, now you can move, make changes, you guys can do anything you want to. Whenever you make a change, it will automatically re-render and adjust. If you guys want to adjust the lighting, go to the lighting in here. As you guys can see, you can change all settings for lighting. For an example, you guys can change the placement of the lighting from here. You can see every time I change, it's re-rendering and adjusting the lighting automatically. With this, you can physically change the placement of the lighting using these settings, such as the height placement of the light or intensity of the light, or even you can control the ambient light intensity as well. So what I'm trying to do in here is, since we have applied the materials three times for three different objects, it will have three different lights with these three different objects, but I want to make them to look like one single object, and there is only one light affecting that one single object. In order to do that, you have to adjust all of these individual lights, place it in the same place, and make this look like one single object. So that's what I'm trying to do in here. You have to create an imaginary place where is your light is going to be. If the light is in here, how it's going to affect all of these three different surfaces if it's a one object. So let's say we are going to place our light in here. Okay, so this is where our imaginary light is going to be. In here, this side, we will have very less ambient light. And this side, we will have little bit more ambient light, little bit more intensity. You guys can on the shadow temporarily. I'm not going to use this shadow. This shadow will not suit our artwork. This will only put if you only have one object. But for now, I will on this shadow so that we can easily see the placement of the light. So in here, in this case, you can see the light placement is perfectly all right. Let's do the same for the top text group as well. Select the top text group, and in here, let's on the shadow just to see where is the light placement is. I think placement wise, this is also looking good. Okay, so now we can hide these shadows. If you want to edit the light in here, you can use the rotation of the lighting intensity and hide. For this text effect, now lighting is all right for the top and the right text groups. But for the left text group, we need to bring the light a little bit more darker because now it's too bright based on our light placement. We can do that very easily. Before we do that, if you have earlier closed this material window, for an example, if you already applied the materials and light and did some modification for your shape, example in here, I'm making it a little bit smaller. Now, if you want to go back and edit this lighting again, you can simply select one of these objects, one of these groups, and go to the appearance window. If you guys don't find appearance window in here, you can activate it from Windows panel. So in the appearance window, you can see the 3D and material inside the appearance. You just need to click, which will open the settings for 3D and materials in here. Now let's bring down the intensity of the left text group to maybe 27%. All right, give it some time for render. Now it's appearing with less light, which look perfectly fine with our light placement. You guys can play with the rotation and height as well. You can even change the color of the light. When you change the color, for an example in here, if you change it to yellow color, light yellow color, you can see it's affecting not only the lights, it's also affecting the materials as well. To get to the perfect results, you have to change all three lights to same color. Cool. Now all three materials look the same, and it's look like we have only one light which is affecting the entire object as a box. Alright? Okay, now let's apply a manual shadow. For this, I'm going to use the pen tool and draw a box in here. And we need to bring this to the backwards. You can just simply right click and send it to backward. And then for this, I'm going to apply a darker tone. And we can apply the filters, Gaussian blur. And again, so this shadow also going to be based on our light placement, the imaginary light which we have created. So now everything looks all right. It's look like a 3D object created from a 3D application, but this is actually vector object. You can again go back and edit if you want to, and it's look really nice. All right guys, so that's all about it for today. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.